when the British Royal Air Force was just beginning, two twin flyboys sought to soar above and defend the skies. But their first flight was quite a disaster, and they continued to crash, and crash, and crash, and of course, crash. Could it be possible that God would now use their special talents in the remotest place on Earth? Journey with us now to their island getaway to see what has become of the long-lost Banzai brothers and see the wonders that God can do.
Hello, hello, my little dearies. It is I, Mumsy. Oh, it is so... Thank you now, children. Yes, it is so good to have my dear sweet Popsy with us. It's been so long since we've had the whole family together. Oh, I hear him now.
Where is she? Where is my wee little bride?
Oh, there
you are, Mabel. How are you, sonny? Come here, Mabel. Let me give you a great
big bear
hug.
That's enough out of you. You squeezed me so hard last night, my hat popped off.
Oy, that was my anaconda squeeze.
Yes, well, I am not an anaconda. I am your wife.
Ah, Mabel, I can't help it. I just love you so. I missed you, darling.
I know.
I say, Mabel, why don't you and I go on a little vacation?
Well, but it's so lovely here. I mean, where would we go?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe Easter Island. Ooh. I hear it's Easter all year round there.
Oh, well, that does sound lovely.
Yeah, we can hunt for giant Easter eggs.
Oh, but what will we do about 800-pound gorilla? He's right in the middle of his flying lessons.
Well, we could take him with us. Yeah, he'll have a blast. I'll even let him fly the aeroplane.
I don't know. It's just I'm enjoying this special family time so much. It's been so long since we've had the whole family together.
Aye, family is important.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and I'm so proud of my little monkey toes and boo-boo kitty.
Who?
Chauncey and Algernon.
Oh, I thought you were still talking about that 800-pound gorilla.
No, silly, I'm talking about our sons. They've become such strong, powerful men of God.
Well, I don't know, that algae is a bit of a skinny thing. Each time I wrestle them, I feel like I'm going to snap them in half like a twig.
No, Popsy, I'm not talking about their bodies. I'm talking about their character. Our sons are serving the Lord with all their hearts, minds, and souls.
Well, that's because we raised them right, Mumsy. Taught them to be godly men like Jesus.
Yes, that's right. And you kids need to know that as you grow, they learn to love Jesus just like he did.
And you must remember to respect God's power. Hey, Jesus was Lord over everything, even death. Like that time he gave old Lazarus a wake-up call. Remember that one?
Oh, yes, I remember that story. Why don't we read it to the kids?
Oh, great idea, Mabel. Let me get out the Bible right now.
I believe in miracles.
Ah, here you go, my love.
Thank you, dear. I've got a miracle right here. It's in the book of John.
Aye, that's when Jesus' poor friend Lazarus passed away.
He did what?
He passed away. He cacked the bucket. He died!
Oh, yes. He passed away. Yes, I remember now. Lazarus had been quite sick. And then his friends, sisters Mary and Martha, had sent a message asking Jesus to come right away.
Aye, but when Jesus heard about it, he'd said a very curious thing. He told his disciples this sickness would not end in death. He said it was for God's glory, so that God's Son may be glorified.
Now, what do you suppose that Jesus meant by that?
Well, to glorify Jesus means to honor Jesus with praise. So I think he's going to do a miracle!
Oh, no!
A miracle! Oh, no! Now, when Jesus arrived, Lazarus had already passed away, and his poor little sisters were crying their wee little eyes out. And when Jesus met up with Martha, he told her, "Your brother's going to rise again."
Yes, and Martha said, "I know he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day."
Now, what did Martha mean by that?
Well, she believed what the scriptures promise, that those who believe in the Lord will go to heaven.
Aye, but Jesus did an even more amazing thing. He said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?
Oh, I believe it, Popsy.
Well, that's because it's true, Mumsy. Jesus has resurrection power.
Yes, he does. But resurrection is an awfully big word, Popsy.
Well, we serve an awfully big Lord. But resurrection simply means to bring back to life. It's being raised from the dead.
Popsy, are you telling me that Jesus has the power to bring dead people back to life?
Well, kids, who created life in the first place? God, aye?
Yes.
And who gave Jesus all power to rule over heaven and earth? God, aye?
Yes, yes, so it makes sense that Jesus has the power over both death and life.
Aye, and I can prove it too,
right,
straight from the Word of God. Listen to what happened next. There was a giant stone in front of the cave where Lazarus was buried. And Jesus told them, take away the stone.
Yes, so they moved the stone, and then Jesus thanked the Father for hearing them.
And then Jesus called out in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out! And Lazarus obeyed Lord Jesus and came right out of that cave. He was alive. It was a miracle!
A miracle!
A miracle!
A miracle! I believe it, Popsy.
Well, you know what Jesus said? Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?
Well, I see his glory and resurrection power. It is incredible.
Aye, and you lads and lasses know what else is incredible, don't you? Everybody, let's say it together. Pinkies up. It's incredible but true what the God of wonders can do.
So long, kitties. Bye-bye.
Love and kippers.
Let's go, Dolly.
All right, Mabel, right this way.
Bye.